grassland management has become a big issue for a lot of farms. From a week to 10 days ago, we're in the midst of a fodder crisis, and now we're going to go into an issue where grassland management and utilising the volume of grass that has grown over the last number of days will become an issue. A lot of stock still not let out on farms at the moment, so a lot of the smaller stock or cattle and or calves still need to be let out. The key message what we want to deliver here today is that don't forget the dosing regime. A lot of farms have expanded in cow numbers over the last months and years, so this will only have a larger impact on the worm burden that will be there in pasture. So the key component is to make sure that you have a strong dosing regime set out from the start of the year. Make sure that you know the system that you want to be in for the year. There's a lot of good systems there that are equally as effective on farms, but is to have your plan set out that of the product type, the product system, and the range of products that you're going to use during the year will be the key beneficiary for the actual good dosing worming program. There's a lot of products and a lot of ranges there that will do equally as good a job, but is to make sure that you're in the correct system that suits your cow type, your animal type, and both your land type to most. Make sure that anyone that's milking cows utilize the bulk milk disease screen testing. Persistence in products can go from anything from 12 hours to up as far as 17 weeks. So make sure that you know the product that you're using and the worming and the dosing intervals that you need. Some people will revert back to type to the white and yellow type doses that have persistence levels up from 12 to 24 hours. But the problem is with these is that oral dosing a volume of stock is both labor intensive, and the level of cover that's needed and the dosing interval will be down as far as low as 3 and 4 weeks. So just absolutely they will do a good job, and just to be aware of the presence of worms that are on your farm that you're trying to deal with. Moving on from that then, as well, you have the ivermectin range. Ivermectins have become the product of choice over the last number of years, whether in the form of injectable or poron, and just to make sure that the using the correct product to suit, and from the withdrawal periods to suit your animal type as well. 2 to 3 weeks persistence on these products with a dosing interval of 5 to 6 weeks. Just to be aware of this as well, not to create an alarm or hysteria, but to be aware of it, there was a quality article on the Irish Farmers Journal a number of weeks ago detailing the better farmers and the dosing regime that they were using on that farm. A key note to take from that article was the level of resistance that is starting to build up to ivermectins over the country. Absolutely, they are quality products and used in the correct manner have a part to play. But to be aware of this, that because of the price and the value that they have been over the last number of years, people have probably become over dependent on them. Moving on to that then, we had the longer actings then, the Dectamax and the Cydectin range, which are basically given 5 to 6 weeks of persistence with a dosing interval of approximately 8 weeks. These are key products that will have a big part to play in the 2018 dosing regime system, in my opinion, as labour, as I said, is a huge issue and the dosing interval is stretched out. A lot of the replacement heifers and cattle and calves are now being reared on out farms where the labour is probably not present and the handling facilities may not be as up to speed as the home farm. So with a dosing regime of every 8 weeks, this is reduced on the labour and the number of dosing intervals in the product that's required. As mentioned earlier on then as well, there's the Cydectin LA, which is primarily going to be used on our dairy calves, giving cover of up to 17 weeks. This is an injection of 1 mL per 100 kilos into the ear of the calf. Careful attention and detail must be taken to the injection site, and to make sure and ask the advice from your local vet or your business manager for the correct use of the product. This is an ideal dosage for calves. The regime should be to let the calves out for 3 weeks to build the burden up, and that will bring us then to approximately mid-May. And then if used incorrectly in timing, this could actually be the single only dose used pre-housing, as the worm burden will be nil over the summer months because of the persistence of the product. Use of epinomectins will play a key part in the dairy cow industry within Ireland in 2018. A large number of farms, as outlined earlier, have greatly expanded, and the level of worm burden will only increase over the summer months. Results taken year to date have shown that the level of worm presence is quite low at the moment, even though worm conditions and lungworm cycle conditions are quite favourable. Farmers have not been out to be able to utilise the grass, so the presence and of the lungworm is quite low for the time of year. Use of the epinomectins is the key thing, is to use them in the correct timing and to utilise the results given to farmers to make sure that they're using the product in the correct volume and the correct time. Going earlier possibly might be the correct thing to do on most farms to clear out that worm burden. As the cow numbers increases and growth rates will fluctuate during the year, paddocks will get grazed out tighter, and it's to make sure that we're utilising this grass is the key component, but also this will have a positive impact then on the level of worm presence as well, to use the epinephrine then to make sure that this burden is reduced on cows across the summer months.